Hello all, welcome to AuraTrainings.com. In this session, we'll discuss about interactive grid report. Let's get into agenda. We'll understand about what is interactive grid report, some of the customizations in the interactive grid report, and also a live sample of interactive grid report. Let us understand what is interactive grid report first of all. We know what is a report. A report is nothing but a formatted result from a database. But what is interactive grid report specially is like it provides set of data where user can search and also where user can customize. Not only that, it provides us the capability of providing a DML operation, nothing but you can edit the row, you can update the row, you can delete the row, and that's all DML functionalities also can be provided in the interactive grid report. Okay, now we'll try to discuss about some of the customizations in the interactive grid report, like performing the CRUD operations and control break, as well as creating a chart. Let us see the steps involved in creating a report. It can be any report generally. For like if you are trying to create an interactive grid report, the only change you have to select is the third step change. You need to select a report type of interactive grid report. So the first thing what we require is we need to log into Apex. Next, you have to create an application, then create a page and make sure that you select the report type as interactive grid report. And then to select the source, it can be a table or a query, or it can be REST data source, and then you can run the page. Okay, so now we'll quickly go to the Oracle Apex website and let us see the creation of the report now. So this is one of the sample interactive grid report which Oracle provided from the sample reporting repository. Okay, so we'll try to create a similar report now. So I'll click on App Builder. Okay, I'll use the existing application, or if you don't have any existing application, you can simply create an application and then you can create a report. Okay, so I'll click on this particular Apex application now. And then here, if you observe, I already have two types of reports, like one is classic report and another one is interactive report. Now in today's session, we'll create interactive grid report. I'll click on create page. And here you need to select the page type as report. And then once you select page type as report, it provides a list of pages of type report. And here, these are the provided types in the Apex. In our case today, we'll select interactive grid. Once you select interactive grid, automatically it will navigate to another dialog. It will auto generate a page number. You can go with the default, and then you mention the page name. Okay, I'll go with the default. I'll not change any other thing. Click on next. And here I'll prefer to have a new navigation entry. And here I'll go with the default. Click on next. Now here you can select the source type as table or SQL query. And also one more important thing is, as of now I selected by default, the selection is local database. But if you're trying to create your interactive grid report based on the REST enabled SQL service or REST data source, you can select the appropriate one. But we'll discuss this REST enable functionality in the later session. But in today's session, we'll go with a source data source as local database, source type as table, and then we'll just simply mention the table. That's it. And just tab out. It will automatically task to display the columns. If it is not displaying columns, then what is the preferred ways? Click on this particular one and you search the list of tables which are available in your workspace. Okay, so these are the list of tables which are available in my workspace. So I selected the EMP now. Okay. Yeah, sometimes it is quite slow, but yeah, it's fine. I selected EMP and then click on create. Okay. Our report is almost ready. Let's run the report and see how it looks like. Okay. So this is how interactive grid report looks like. Okay. Now here, if you observe, it is not providing any add or update functionality by default. Okay, what you have to do is, you'll go to page designer. Okay, you can also go to page designer from here. Like if you just observe here, you can simply click on edit page. It will directly go here itself. Now, click on this particular content body in the interactive grid report region. And here on the attributes, you just simply click on edit enabled. Okay, once you click on edit enabled, by default, it provides a list of operations are allowed on the report. Now just click on run and you can see the add, save, edit. You can see them by default. Okay. Now we can modify any of the record. Let's say I'll just say 5% and click on save. We should be able to see the updated data. And similarly, we can delete the data. You can add the data also. I'll click on add. Yep, I could add the data now. 150. Okay. Click on save. The data will get saved. That's it. And if at all, if you want to delete it, you can select the record here and you can delete it. Okay. Now, the other customization which I would like to show you is like now click on actions. On the format, click on control break. So control break is nothing but a representation of group by representation. Now let us say I want to see all the data based on a department, nothing but for each department, I want to group the data and see the employees. I'll just click on control break. Now you mention the column here. I'll select department number and just click on save. That's it. So now I could see the data, a group by kind of fashion report, a group by kind of report where I could see the employees are grouped based on the department number. It's nothing but a group above report. From you, if you're coming from a reporting background, it's nothing but a group above report. Okay, now I'll just unselect this one. I'll delete it. Now the next thing I want to show is like a creation of a chart. So in the actions, you just click on chart. Okay, I'll click on bar chart. Now I just want to display the salary with respect to department. So I'll select department here. And the value is nothing but salary. And aggregation is nothing but sum. And click on save. Now we should be able to see the summation of salary with respect to each department. Okay. So these are some of the functionalities which we can do in the interactive grid report. Okay. So, but the major difference between interactive report and grid report is the edit functionality. Here, if you observe the interactive report earlier, which we have done. Sorry, this is an interactive grid report, right? And this is a classic report. Okay. So these are the major functionalities which you can do in the grid report. And of course, you can do the search functionality, right? Let's see. Okay. So try it out. And this is all about the interactive grid report. Thank you.